Hi, and welcome to this ForNAV Coffee Break. My name is René Brümmel. I'm a product specialist at ForNAV, and I will be your presenter today. With me today is Jacob Rasmussen to answer any question you may have about ForNAV Direct Print and File Service. As this coffee break is live, you can ask your questions via the GoToWebinar question window. We will answer them at the end of the coffee break. Today, we're going to access local files on your local drive from Business Central Cloud. One of the biggest issues using cloud infrastructure is that the cloud typically has no way of using the existing on-premise applications. With ForNAV, we have previously fixed the use of local printers from Business Central Cloud, and we have now added access to your local files and drives as well. To demonstrate local file access, I'm going to use these steps. Prerequisites, what do I need to get going? In step two, I will set up my local file storage. In step three, I will read data from my local file storage. And in step four, I will write data to my local file storage. Let's start with the first step. Today, I will work in the Business Central Cloud tenant with the Business Central 2023 Wave 2 release. I've installed the ForNAV customizable report pack, and I've executed the step-by-step wizard from the assisted setup to get started. Of course, everything I do today will work for an on-premise environment as well. I've also installed the ForNAV Designer and the ForNAV Direct Print and File Service, both of which can be downloaded from the ForNAV web service. So the first thing we are going to do is set up access to the local files. We will discuss the full Direct Print and File Service setup in a separate coffee break, so I'm only going to discuss the basics here. So what I'm going to do today is I have set up a separate server, which is actually a cloud server hosted on Azure. And on this separate server, I want to read my local files from my local file system. So to do that, first thing I need to do is install the ForNAV Direct Print. To do so, simply download the setup executable from the ForNAV website. And then you need to install at least the Direct Print and File Service. That's what is necessary to read the files and use the printers on your local machine. You can use this on any server or any computer for that matter. You don't need a server that has Business Central installed on it. Anything is fine. And like I said, this is just a normal standard server that we have lying around for development work. So if you install that, I just need to start the Direct Print and File Service. You get the Direct Print and File Service installed. And the next step is to open the client and to import a business access to a Business Central environment. So you need to set that up from Business Central. To do so, simply go to Business Central, and you will notice that I'm opening Business Central on my local machine. This is a tricky coffee break for me to do because I'm working on two machines at the same time. So I am going to find the ForNAV Direct Print setup. And in the ForNAV Direct Print setup, you can find the service keys. And the service keys you need to download. And you need to import that in your Direct Print server. So I'm going to copy that from my local machine and paste it in my server that I want to use the Direct Print on. I can double click it, and that's going to import the Business Central environment in my ForNAV Direct Print. And you will notice that everything starts to get going and the status is now waiting. So I'm ready to use the Direct Print on my local machine. The next step, of course, is to test this Direct Print. And to test, we have some nice features for you. In the Direct Print installation file folder, which is typically in the C program data ForNAV Direct Print, you can find a demo files setup. And this demo file setup is created automatically, and you can use these to demonstrate how Direct Print works. You can test this with a separate extension that we have created. I'm going to share the link to this extension later on at the end of the webinar. But this separate extension that you can test is the ForNAV files demo, which you can find on our GitHub page. You can simply clone it and run it. And if you install that in Business Central, you can find the ForNAV files demo page in Business Central. And in there, you can simply test some basic features. You can scan your directory, and that will tell me I've got a readme.txt. And if I look on my server in the folder, you can see that I've got a readme.txt. You can click on that, which will open it. And you can see the folder is a simple sample. Of course, from here, I can write a text file, which will write a simple text file in my local file, which is right here. If I open it, it says hello world. And of course, you can change that. Do something else. And then of course, from Business Central, you can read those local files as well. You can read the text file. And that gives you the file content, hello, coffee break crowd. How this works, if we look at this extension, you will see, for instance, in the write text function, that we call a ForNAV file service code unit with the function write text. And this function takes the location and the file. The demo files is the alias. I will discuss where to find that later on. And it will add some plain text in a text file. And you can use that to create text files, to create CSV files, JSON files, anything you like. You can have your text encoding, etc. To read those files is pretty much the same thing. You have a fileservice.readText function, which reads the text from a specific file in your folder with a specific text encoding. And you can play around with this, of course. And the next step, at least the one that I was really curious about, is how do I save reports in my local files, and how can I read PDF files? So not just the data from a text file, but I want to read the entire file. And that's going to be my next step. I'm going to read a local file, and I want to append this local file to a ForNAV report as a simple appendix. To do so, I've created a new code unit that will read the file from the local folder and make it available inside the ForNAV layout. Those of you that are familiar with our coffee breaks know that we have what is called a temporary file inside ForNAV reports, which means that I can take any table inside Business Central, make it temporary, and use some code inside an AL extension to populate it. So what I've done is I've created a new table, which is my ForNAV local file, which takes the alias and the file name, and it gives you the data as a blob field. And I've created a code unit that reads data from my local file, which subscribes to the on ForNAV fill temporary table event, which is the event that's going to fill data in read data and fill it in inside a temporary table. And if you follow the code in here, we go to fill local files. Come on. Where we save the values from a filter, which is fairly standard, and we can add local files to the blob field. And if I go into the add local files function, you will find once again, I'm going to check if my file exists. So in here, I'm going to do a file service file exist, and I'm going to get the path based on an alias and a file name. And I'm going to create an outstream. In a file service, I'm going to read from stream. You will remember in the earlier setup, we read from text. In this case, we're going to read from stream. So I'm going to grab the entire PDF and load it into my local file.data blob field. Now, of course, to set this up, I need to tell the Direct Print server where my files are stored. Now, the files are stored on my server in my C test folder. And to tell ForNAV Direct Print where that test folder is, I'm going to go to my C program data ForNAV Direct Print folder into the configuration where I can find a config.json. I will open this with code. And you can see in here that I've got a list of file shares, and at the moment it says demo files in here with the path program data ForNAV, which is the standard demo file that you get. And I can simply add a new file in here, where the alias is going to be coffee break, which points to the path C test. Save this. Restart the Direct Print service, because the Direct Print service reads the config file on starting. So that's all of the plumbing done. Now all I need to do is open my ForNAV report. I'm going to use the invoice today. And in the ForNAV report, I need to add my temporary file, which is going to be called ForNAV local file, which is a new table that I've created. Then there, I need to set temporary to true. So ForNAV will execute the event to fill the data. I need to calculate my data field, so I can actually get the data for my blob field. And I need to tell ForNAV what file to get. So I'm going to set the alias to coffee break. And I'm going to set the file name to the file that I want to read. And the file I want to read is coffee break appendix. Let's copy that. And if you look at this, it's a simple PDF file, which is completely orange, so it stands out a little bit. Then I'm going to set that as the file name. Hit OK. And that's going to open my temporary table and read the file from the ForNAV local file storage. Now all I need to do is tell ForNAV how to actually append this. And we can do that with a simple command in the onpre report. And if you're curious about appending and prepending files to ForNAV reports, we have some coffee breaks on how to do that. So please have a look if you want to see how that works and what else you can do with it. So I've set everything up, save report on server and activate. Refresh my page. Let's run my report. There we go. I now append a file from my local file storage to a report in Business Central Cloud, which I think is pretty cool. Now, finally, we also want to store data from Business Central in the local folder. So to do that, to demonstrate that, I'm going to store the PDF output from our ForNAV report in our local storage. Now, again, let's open my extension to do this. We've seen before that we can write simple text files and just do a write text and create a new file from text. What we can also do, I have a simple page extension here on the posted sales invoice, which is going to save my report in a file stream, in a file outstream. And I get this file outstream from my report save as, and I want to save that in my local file storage. And to do that, I need to create an instream from it and then call the ForNAV file service with write from stream, where I'm going to specify where I want to save this. So I'm going to save it in my alias coffee break, and the file name is %1.pdf, and %1 is the sales invoice header number. And I'm going to store my file in stream. Again, I'm going to share all this code with you so you can play around with this at your leisure. This has been already been uploaded to Business Central. So in Business Central, I can open my sales, posted sales invoices, where in my sales invoice, I will find my button save to local file. And if I run that, it takes a minute to render the report and store it. And if I now go to my server, you'll find I've got 103.198.pdf, which is my ForNAV report with the appendix. So let's recap what we just did. The first thing we did was to set up the direct print and file server signaling. We downloaded the setup file from Business Central, opened it in the direct print and file service, and that was done. We then had a look at some of the ForNAV demo code for the direct print and file service. After that, we looked at how to read a file from the local folder. We set up a new folder and alias in our direct print and file service, and we added the code to read data from that and make it available inside a ForNAV report layout. Finally, we saved the report directly in our folder on the local server. As always, the code for the custom tables is available in our GitHub repository, and we have a separate GitHub repository for the ForNAV demo files extension. And I can really recommend you downloading those two extensions and playing around with this. I can also now say that the ForNAV temporary file table, which I used in this case as a simple pretenant extension, will be included in the next version of ForNAV, which will be 7.4 or above. Thank you very much for listening to me so far. I can see we have some questions. If you have any questions at this point, which I can imagine, please type them in the GoToWebinar question box. First question, Jacob, is can the files also be stored on a network device or a UNC path?
And the answer to that is yes. When you create the alias in the config file, you can add a path that starts with --, and then a server name and a share name. That works. It will of course need the proper Windows permissions to access this path, and the user context is set on the service. So if it requires a special user context to access the files on the UNC path, you need to change the user on your service. I hope that answers the question. So I would not use the mapped letter. I would use the full UNC path instead.
Thank you, Jacob. I can't see any further questions, so I will proceed with wrapping up this coffee break. If you want to know more about ForNAV, or if you want to download the ForNAV Designer and Converter, please visit our website. If you want to install ForNAV in Business Central Cloud, please visit the Microsoft App Source. You can watch more videos about ForNAV on our YouTube channel. If you have any questions about ForNAV, please email them to support@fornav.com. For a full list of upcoming and recorded coffee breaks, please visit fornav.com/coffee break. Thank you very much for joining me today, and goodbye.